Hello again, and welcome back to the Ninja Ranch here on YouTube. My name is Ninja Cowboy, and this is going to be the first main video of our No Perks Every Biome walkthrough on how I succeed at winning consistently. I appreciate you guys for hanging out with me today. Remember that you do have the subscribe button down below if you enjoy this video. But I am going to start my run here in the mines. And again, I love this game. I love the randomness of the game. And I hope you guys enjoy this walkthrough here. So basically, I'm going to be going from biome to biome to biome, taking no perks, only off the spells that I get on my wands, and kind of doing a walkthrough on what we like to look for to help us in the following biomes and what to do in the current biome. So here we are in the very beginning of the game. We're starting off with a bouncing burst, regular bomb, and a water flask. I play on controller. Everyone has their own preference of where to put their wands and their primary flask. A lot of people are comfortable with having their main wand here and their water flask here. I personally feel comfortable having my main wand on the end and my main flask there, so I can switch back and forth really quickly to increase my wetness to remove any fire or toxic or anything like that. One of the first tips is to remove fire or toxic very quickly is you just aim straight up, spray, and float slowly up into it, and that'll make you wet quicker. So let's move on. We're starting with a bouncing burst attack spell here, and it's really my least favorite of beginning projectiles. It can be a very efficient projectile late game if you can get a lot of increased speed to the projectile, to the point where it can nearly pretty much just one-shot the final boss. You see here, as soon as I see toxic falling, I like to remove that toxic by just sprinkling a little bit of water into it and move on. I like to always have my water flask full, so as soon as I find an opportunity to fill my water flask completely, I do it every single time. So one of these strats that I like to do here on the first floor, if RNG allows me, is I like to make my way all the way to the right-hand side by the lava lake as soon as possible. That looks like an ambrosia flask that I would like to get without it being destroyed. It is. We start off with an ambrosia. Ambrosia is a liquid substance that makes you impervious to all damage around you. It does not prevent you from getting polymorphed, but it does prevent all damage as long as the ambrosia stain is on your character. So ambrosia is one of the most powerful flasks in the game. So I do like to leave as many enemies alive as possible as I make my way to the right side. Oh goodness, okay. Obviously kicking that body creates a lot more toxic. Your fluids do not mix inside the flask, they mix outside the flask. So, if you do have some toxic sludge inside your flask, just spray it out and it'll turn into water. The peat here, the light green stuff on top of the water, that's flammable. And it does not affect anything really in any way, but it will contribute to creating swamp in the future. But if you have too much of it in your flask, But I do like to keep as many enemies alive as possible until I can get to the tablet that's on the right-hand side over here. Depending on if we started with maybe magic missiles, we would go and get the tablet at the top of the mountain from the beginning. But with this run, we're starting with the generic bomb and bouncing burst. Now, this is a really nice wand to find in the first biome. It is a shuffle wand, but this is one of the most desired wands to find in the first biome, with it having the very low recharge time, very low cast delay. Absolutely awesome wand. And if this is a wand that we're probably going to use throughout the first and second biomes. So now that we have this, I like to make that my primary wand because it is very, very powerful, especially with that Spitter Bolt spell on there. We do have a Flaming Banana Headman over here. I don't particularly try to remember their exact names. I like to make up my own names. Ow. Okay, he will die. Obviously, we're not going for a no hit here. We're just going for a walkthrough on the biomes. Let's get this toxic changing to water. So now we're at our first step of the first floor. One of my main goals of the first floor is getting close to 1,000 gold and perhaps a heart container or two before moving on to the next floor. And there's a heart container. But I use this tablet to kill enemies, which 9 times out of 10 will give you a trick kill and giving you double money. There is a throw kick strat to this, where you can basically kick the tablet at the simultaneously as you throw it, and it'll make it fly a lot faster and do a lot more damage. It is a very tricky thing to do on controller. I think it's much easier to do probably on mouse and keyboard. I don't know. I don't play mouse and keyboard, but there is a way to master it if you want to spend the time. I think on controller you just do a kick and then a throw, and the tablet will run into your kick. But I don't really want to spend the time trying to master that right now in the middle of my video. So, like I said, I like to keep most of the enemies alive so that I can kill them with the tablet and get twice the money or take random damage. Spiders, I really enjoy seeing. Well, this Flaming Banana Headman's kind of going to make our life a little difficult. So, let's sprinkle some water down here and see if we can get him to jump down below. So much for that money from those spiders, but it is what it is. We're gonna try to get him to jump down into the water down below and die from the water down there. Yes, see? Worked perfectly. Now one of our main goals is to try to find more water and top off our water flask, because we want that to be completely full, especially for when we run into these flaming banana headmen. You need to use quite a bit of a flask to set him up for failure. It looks like we might have ourselves a little bit of a special room up there, but we'll get to that in a little bit. I like to full clear every floor that I can, if possible. Let's have a look. Slime balls are pretty good. They're decent for digging. It might actually be a pretty solid wand to get. And it looks like there's no penalty for taking this wand from here, because usually there's an electrical box here. Ooh, that's a really nice wand right there. Let's actually just drop a little bomb right here. Let all this burn. See if we can get rid of this oil stain. Now that red wand that looks similar to the wand that I'm holding, but it's red and gold, is actually a really nice wand to get early on as well. Let's take this slime ball wand. That'll help us with some minor digging through light dirt. And we come to a spark bolt with trigger. That is awesome. I'll explain that later. But right now, let's just worry about survival. And enjoying the music of this game. They really have improved the music of the game. I'm going to try to get... Let's take care of this guy first. I don't usually try to just kill this guy with a tablet. He is a shotgunner. He can do a lot of damage with his shotgun shots. So I just like to just kill him straight up as fast as possible. These dynamite guys, however, are a little bit less dangerous. And you see I switched to my tablet right away. Looks like we got ourselves a chest. I'm gonna turn this sludge into some water. And pardon me while I sneeze. Goodness. Bless you, excuse me. Let's get this toxic changed into water and top off our flask. As you can see, this wand has a pretty fast fire rate, castellate, recharge times are low, and the spark bolt with trigger early on is really, really nice, and I'll show you that here in a little bit. But let's just get our water flask full and proceed through this beautiful, beautiful biome. Location, Holy Mountain. If you're ever curious as to where you are, if you press start and look down here in the bottom left-hand corner, you have your seed, the date, April. Oh, this build is April 9th, 2021. Today is actually the 11th. New game mode, and the location is the mines. So, if you're ever curious as to just where you are, that is the way to resolve that. These guys are kind of a pain to kill with a tablet, so I like to just do that as well. And let's start murdering everything we see. If I miss, I just go ahead and kill with my wand. It's not that serious. We do have an explosive box here. I'm going to try to use this box for opening up this little chest that we have here. It's a little tricky to get a hang of how to kick things around, but looks like we got some invisible pixels there. But with a little practice, or a lot of practice, you can get your box to where you want it to be. And there we have it. We've got our chest. Spinner bowl doesn't seem to break that open very well. Looks like we have a liquid vacuum field. That is a spell that you probably want to play around with late game, because it is a little bit tricky. Let's get some kills. We're lucky to do this video without any biome modifiers. Sometimes they have some really ridiculous modifiers that they throw at you in the very first biome. One of which is called, why is it so wet in here, or why is there so much water? And that is a modifier that I strongly dislike, because you do start off the game with a lot of those green guys with the lanterns that throw the what is it called? It's called the cursed sphere. And the sphere itself, I think, only does like 15 damage, but then it makes a thunder lightning cloud follow you and can do some significant damage with the explosion of the lightning. It's just not a good time. But we're fortunate enough to just have ourselves a regular biome. Okay, they didn't want to die. That's fine. Maybe we'll get some fire going and get that to explode here in a little bit. We'll hear it off in the distance. And we missed. The tablet is an art. That's for sure. Mastering the art of the tablet. Now we're dry, so we definitely want to get ourselves wet. And see what we can find. What's happening down here. Looks like we've got ourselves a couple enemies down here that can die on their own because of toxic. That's convenient. It doesn't look like sometimes with this formation where you see like the wood going slanted, you'll find a chest here. Definitely an area that you don't want to pass up if possible. And again, I like to use all the resources I can around me to destroy terrain instead of having to use my bombs, which sometimes you'll need to use just for specific areas that have chests or hearts enclosed. So if you're at a spot where you're like, oh man, I need to blow that up, you know, maybe just take an extra second to try to find an explosive to assist you. Looks like we got ourselves a spider over here. These guys are my favorite because they give 10 gold just for a simple kill. And then the tablet is a trick kill, so it's a double gold. We're just gonna kill this guy. But yeah, first thing is to get the tablet, you do your tablet kills, and that'll help you get a lot of money, because having a lot of money going into the first Holy Mountain can really be a make or breaker type deal. You know, there's especially if you don't have a way of getting out of the Holy Mountain without collapsing it, and you absolutely have to collapse the Holy Mountain, and you just burn all bridges to the Holy Mountain, you're just like, okay, we gotta move on, there's no going back. But there are a couple different ways of getting in and out of the Holy Mountain without collapsing it and without angering the gods as well and having to deal with Stavari, or whom I call Scuba Steve. Let's get this started. I usually like to get fire going where fire is needed. This guy spews out so much toxic, it's ridiculous. Alright, so that right there is a mark, or whatever his Finnish name is, but that is a mark, and they are very deadly. They could actually kill me with me only having my 54 HP. So that is somebody to probably avoid early on if you're not experienced with dealing with them. Maybe just say, you know what, I'm just gonna leave that guy alone. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's plenty of enemies in the game to provide you with money. And that one is one that we can just leave locked in his little timeout zone. He's in there in timeout for a reason. And we're just gonna leave him alone. Let's see if we can get that kill. Beautiful. I like to kick explosives away from me just in case an enemy is down below and just is like, hey, I see that Noida. Let's try to kill that Noida. And then boom, hits you with their shot and explodes the barrel. and really devastates your HP. So, if you're trying to go someplace that is still not revealed because of the fog of war, just kick that little explosive barrel away. I used to be a habit where I would just blow up every explosive barrel that I see, just for fun, because it's the explosions in this game are awesome. But I learned that it's nice to keep them because you might need them. And it almost seems like they're strategically placed in areas because you're gonna need them. But once we get close to the amount of money that we'd like to have, coming over here, we are now in the collapsed mines. If you look here down below, collapsed mines. This is like the NG plus of the mines. This place is a little bit more dangerous, and it will whittle you down and your health fairly quickly. If you have very low health already, I would just say, maybe we can come back. Maybe we can come back to that area later. We have only found one heart container, so I am on the hunt for another one, because the more, the merrier. Now we've got ourselves a situation here with a flaming banana head man, and it's looking like he's gonna want to fight. So we need to find a way to get him soaked in water, and this is probably our best bet. So we'll just let this trickle down. Try to get his attention. I don't want to use all my water, right? You don't ever want to use all your water because you're going to need that water again for making more water from toxics. Oh, shoot, he went up above. All right, let's try to get his attention. A couple shots at him. Say hello. Hello. See if we can get him to come down here. And he should drop into that water, maybe, in a perfect world. But it seems like he likes to go in the direction that you are. Even if you're under him or above him, he will try to he'll walk in that general direction. But we do got ourselves some more water here, so let's see if we can just get this water going. And that'll run off over there. Kind of using my angles here. Oh, he's above us. So yeah, we just kind of walk over here. He'll walk this way. Say hello. There we go. We got him. A little bit of patience pays off because he drops a lot of money. So again, we go top off our water flask because this is really the most important flask in the game. There are some other flasks that are really important to get for special areas to get to and whatnot in the game, but water flask is obviously very important. So these frogs are ridiculous, and I'm going to try to maybe just get one. Two? Nope. So we'll just murder those guys. But those frogs are like the supermen of frogs. It's pretty ridiculous. Let's take the high ground here and just kind of have a look around. See if we're missing anything. Get that out of here. Get our kill. But yeah, this place is pretty dangerous, if you ask me. Sometimes you can squeeze through little areas like that. It looks like we might have to get some coal burning to get to where we want to be. So we will blow those up and see what we find down below. This guy is ridiculous because he just scatters gunpowder everywhere, and it's pretty absurd the range of his attack. But he also is immune to fire, but I don't think he's immune to explosion, so there's a chance that he will kill himself. From time to time, if you're lucky, on a good day. This is just a standard blue wand. It's probably a wand with like a bomb on it or something, but let's see if we can get this into a better position. Maybe it'll sit up here. Possibly, maybe, possibly. Right, maybe we'll, nope. That's actually kind of a sketchy place. We do have slime balls, so let's see what a slime ball can do for us here. It is a slow digging projectile, and it really doesn't like to dig through this damp rock. It just likes to dig through the ground. But I really want to see what's on that wand. So let's go up above and see if we can find something else. There is a little shotgun heesy guy chilling down there, whatever, marauder, or whatever you want to call him. We'll take care of him later. Can we duck under this? We cannot, but we do have slime ball. That was close. That was close. That was a little more than we. Ooh, and look what we found. Another heart container. That's a beautiful sight. Now, don't get too excited and try to go right away and rush it, because you might get yourself into some trouble. But we can slime ball this wood very easily and just goink. Grab that. Make sure that our back is clear. It's always nice to go from left to right of the level, or right to left of a level, just so that you know that you've cleared everything behind you and you do not get bum rushed. So in this area here is a really dark cave that even the only thing they can reveal that with is All Seeing Eye perk. The All Seeing Eye spell will not work. Looks like we got ourselves a lava potion. I really don't see any huge use for lava potion, except for maybe if you want to do some shifting lava later, which we have shifted lava to gunpowder before, and that was pretty cool when you got to pass the boss, but that's late game. I'm gonna use a wand, a bomb here, because it doesn't seem like there's any way through. I just have a peek at what's on here. Circle of Freezing. Okay. I am a fan of Circle of Freezing, and I will show you that later. The slime balls, you know, it's nice. It's a non-shuffle wand, but we do have these two great low cast delay, low recharge time shuffle wands that we can utilize for a little while. This is just kind of a mediocre non-shuffle wand, and the slime balls, eh, I could really use the Circle of Stillness a lot more. So I'm gonna keep that bad boy. Get our kills here. This guy should jump down, maybe not. Yeah. Didn't seem like we got the trick kill there, but we got the kill, period. So we have accomplished what we were trying to do here on the first area, and that is get a heart container or two, along with $1,000. Obviously, proceeding through everything very slowly. Now, in this dark cave, okay, this is the transition area between the collapsed mines and the alchemy lab, where there's a mini boss over there. There's a lot of crazy, crazy liquids that you can gather and try to find, you know, infinite gold or infinite healing and all that stuff. But that level, that area over there is, it's kind of mid game to late game for for a rookie, in a sense, rookie player. So if I have any extra bombs, I like to just break this, see this little wall here? I like to break this open and just get that destroyed, because we might come back. We might come back into this dark cave, because in this dark cave is a health up and a health refill. And there is ways to getting them without being able to see, without the all-seeing eye. And we are going to be taking no perks through this playthrough. So if we get the resources that we need to go in there, I will go show you how to find that heart, those hearts and health refill. We do have 50 HP remaining, so I like to really utilize all the resources I can. And get as much money as I can before leaving. Again, if I get down around 30 HP on this first biome, I am steering myself closer to the exit. Because that's not a good amount of HP. Even though we have found some heart containers, we want to make sure that we don't lose those heart containers and waste our time on this first floor. But as you can see, we've pretty much done a full clear using the tablet for the majority of our kills and bringing our money up to over 1,300, which is really nice. We do have a slime boy over here. Let's see if we can get maybe this out of the way. I want to just get this money from this guy. It's a little bit, but every little bit counts and helps in our ultimate goal. If I kill him now, his money will go up above that wood. So let's wait for it to burn a little bit. Gather our money. And he came down, so we got lucky. We didn't have to deal with that shenanigans. So yeah, I just kind of breeze back through this area just to have a look, see if there's any enemies that I can kill that I've left. This oil area sometimes likes to hide a secret. There might be a secret up here. Doesn't look like it. But these kind of like curved tunnels sometimes lead up to a chest or a heart container. But I'm pretty happy with what we found here on this first area. Made my way all the way to the right over here. So I think it's safe to say, you know, we got enough money, we got enough health for now to move on. So we're going to drop into this first holy mountain. A lot of people like to skip the heart, skip the spell refresher. Look at that. We've got all seeing eye spells, which again don't reveal what's in that dark cave, but they're nice for the following biomes. So that is something that we're going to take. These obviously are mediocre perks, but you know what? This is going to be a perkless run. So we're actually really lucky to get these all-seeing eye spells. And with that, that is going to conclude my first video of going through the mines. And we're going to stop here. We've got ourselves some decent wands, some decent spells. And this is looking like it's going to be a good run from the beginning. So I appreciate you guys hanging out with me. I am going to conclude this video for now. You can find me live every day. What is it? Monday through Saturday at 6 p.m. Mountain Time, USA, Colorado. To watch me live on Twitch at twitch.tv/ninjacowboy. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the subscribe button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Comment in the section below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer any questions that you have for you at any time. And I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. And I will continue to show you guys in the next video how I want to build my wand with the resources that were provided to survive in the coal pits and the fungals, which are the two areas in the next biome, using the resources that we have. So again, thank you guys very much for watching, and I hope you all have a wonderful morning, day, or evening, night, wherever you are in this crazy world. Really feels good to be a Ninja Cowboy. And until next time, I'll see you guys. Thank you.